Thank you for your good work.
Thanks. Appreciate you.
Proud of you.
President Russell M. Nelson of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints is commemorating a landmark moment in the latest installment of the Joseph Smith Papers.
These texts were vital to the restoration of the gospel in its fullness. This volume touches my heart deeply.
So there's one page that has Joseph Smith's handwriting on. There's slightly darker ink on these three lines. So this is Joseph Smith's handwriting.
Historian Dr. Robin Scott Jensen holds one of the most important and sacred documents for church members.
This manuscript is as if going back in time and reading Paul's epistles or reading the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
These are the original pages of the Book of Mormon manuscript. It's a key piece of scripture for members of the faith, translated by Joseph Smith, founder and first president of the church.
The Book of Mormon was what started it all. Joseph Smith, according to his own narrative, was visited by an angel where the angel told him about golden plates. Several years later, he was able to obtain those plates and translate the text of the Book of Mormon.
While the Book of Mormon has been in circulation since 1830, this original manuscript is now available to anyone who desires to see it.
This is the manuscript that was in the room with Joseph and Oliver on the table as the words of the Book of Mormon fell from the prophet's lips for the first time.
This is the document that is the closest to that miraculous experience as possible. This manuscript is the product of that divine translation.
The original manuscript was providing something much more valuable. It was allowing us to see Joseph Smith acting as seer, receiving an inspired text, word for word, from the Lord.
According to historians, only about 28% of the original manuscript is still in existence today.
There's an estimated 600 pages, and about 230 of them, we have portions.
The majority of the document's pages were damaged by water in the 19th century while it was stored inside the cornerstone of the Nauvoo House.
There's not much of ether. Moroni is completely gone. But as you go up through the bottom of the manuscript on the top, First Nephi is fairly well preserved.
Nephi obtains the records. This is of Nephi going back to Jerusalem to obtain the brass plates.
After Smith's martyrdom, the manuscript was scattered. Smith's widow, Emma Smith, remarried, and her second husband gave portions of it away to visitors in Nauvoo.
Louis Biedemann had this manuscript, and he started handing it out to visitors. It was a souvenir.
Some of the manuscript's pages were torn into multiple fragments, but over time, historians started the painstaking process of gathering and putting the pages back together.
It's been kind of this historical serendipity where fragments just slowly accumulated into the church.
New multispectral imaging reveals the faintest markings compared to the same images photographed with 1950s technology.
There are pages where it's dramatically improved, where you can read the text, whereas before you couldn't.
We think, well, it would be so cool if everybody could come look at the actual artifact. Our feeling is that what we present in the book, it will be an even better experience in some ways because we've done so much work, painstaking work.
In total, the Joseph Smith Papers will encompass 26 volumes. This latest installment marks the 23rd volume published. The years-long project is possible by a private donation of Gail and her late husband, Larry H. Miller.
I know that this is a divine work. I know that it is an important, almost critical work for the church, for people to be able to go to the work of the Joseph Smith Papers and get the truth.